Today in this video, we are making these amazing waffles at home. These are nothing like the cardboards that we eat outside. These are very crispy from out and fluffy inside. If you add honey to it, these literally absorb everything. Hey foodies, welcome to CookingShooking. Let's make this recipe of eggless waffles at home. Let's begin the recipe for making the waffles or the waffles at home. Here I have a mixing bowl. In this I am taking about 1/3 cup of melted butter. This is salted room temperature butter, guys. Along with this, I'm also taking fresh cream. This is Amul fresh cream, half a packet or about half a cup or so. You don't have to use any whipping cream for this recipe. Fresh cream will totally work. Now we will mix it together for about 1 minute. You can use a fork, spoon or even a spatula like this one. After which we will add the sugar into it. Here I have 2/3 cup of powdered sugar. You can just make this by grinding the sugar into a mixer grinder, after which you can add it inside and then mix it together for about 1 minute minimum. You can see a few lumps here and there. That is because my butter was melted but the cream was cold from the fridge. So we have a few lumps here and there, but don't worry, we will solve that right now itself. You can see the sugar is well incorporated. Now what we will do is we will take 1/3 cup of warm milk. I'm using warm milk just to ensure the butter is melted. So add the milk and then we will give it a mix. If everything is normal for you, then you don't have to use warm milk. You can use room temperature milk and the recipe will be totally perfect. Now this is looking great. Let me take a pinch of baking soda. This is also known as soda bicarb. You will get this easily in the market. Along with this, I'm also taking 1 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. Baking powder is also easily available. You will find it in boxes like this one. So 1 1/4 teaspoon. Now let me give it a mix. Immediately, we will also add the maida or plain flour. In total, I'm taking 130 grams or about 1 cup, but we will add a little at a time. If you add all of it, then there will be lumps in the batter, which we don't want. So one portion at a time, give it a mix and we want a very smooth and lump-free batter. So this recipe was perfect when I made it a few times ago, but since I got a new packet of maida, this one is absorbing more moisture, which is why you can see the batter is very thicker. This will happen with you guys as well. You can see how the batter is looking very thick. What we will do is we will add a little bit of milk to it and then we will give it a mix. This is the main reason, the absorption of liquid is the main reason why most of the times our recipes get a little weird. Dough is very firm sometimes, very soft sometimes, so you can always rectify it by adding more milk or some more of the maida. At the end, we need a batter like this one. You can see it is in flowing consistency, looks great. Now let's make the waffles out of it. To make the waffles, here I have the machine. I prefer using a gas one like this one. You can also use an electric one, the recipe will be the same. So let me turn on the flame. After which what we will do is we will take 2 ladlefuls of the batter and then we will place it in the center. With this waffle maker, I will be able to make 2 waffles at once. In high flame, we have to cook it, guys. No need to apply any butter in the waffle maker. Quickly, let me cover this one out and then we will cook this until it is golden from all the sides. Please do not open it for the first 1 minute, after which you can open it. The problem with my gas stove, as you can see, is the gas is not high enough. It is spread out, so it's perfect for using in pans, but not in recipes like this one or in paneer tikka kind of recipes where we need heat in one place. So if you make it in a regular gas stove where the heat is straight and above, that will be perfect. As you can see, after about 1 minute or so, it has started to cook down. We will cook it until it is golden from both the sides. This one is looking amazing. Because of the baking soda, we will get a nice golden color in this one. If you don't like golden waffles, then you can skip the baking soda in the recipe. Once the waffles are golden, you can take them out and then serve it. This is non-stick, so nothing has stuck to it. So let me take this out into a plate. After which we will serve it hot with some ice cream. But before that, we have to add a generous amount of honey on top of this. If you like maple syrup, then you can also use that. I prefer to use honey. You can see I'm taking it out from a squeezy bottle. This is real honey, guys. That's why it has like stuck in the bottle. It has basically jammed and settled. This is real stuff, guys. I have seen this being taken out from the honeycomb, so I know what I'm eating. You can also use some maple syrup, as I said, if you want to. After adding a generous amount of honey, then you can also place a scoop of ice cream if you prefer that. And a little bit of Nutella or some chocolate syrup doesn't hurt. If you wish, you can also add a little bit of confetti or chocolate chips. And the homemade cafe style waffles are ready. Now let me show you one thing that I was talking about. Here you can see how the gas is like straight and above. In this kind of gas flame, it will be very easy to make the waffles. And if you use the electric ones, nothing like it. So my second batch of waffles are also ready. These also I am serving hot similarly. You can see the texture of the waffles. They are very crispy from outside and inside they are fluffy. Unlike many waffle places I have seen, they are like cardboard, not this one. These are very fluffy from inside and we know what we have added inside. So do try this one out. I am 100% sure you're going to enjoy this recipe of waffles at home. So guys, that was my recipe of the eggless waffles. If you liked it, give it a like button. If you disliked it for any reason, click the dislike button and share your comments in the comment section down below. I hope to see you soon with one more delicious recipe. Bye for now. Take care. Happy cooking.